All right. It's really great. Where are we heading for now?
This particular section is the male adult side of the cell block.
Okay.
Adult males have to be separated from adult females, and juveniles have to be separated from everybody.
So you have three different sections?
This section here is for the adult males. There's four cells. There is one juvie cell and two female cells.
Okay.
In this particular section, and I'll just take in one of them, we'll go right down the cell block.
Okay. Now, these don't look like cells, to be honest with you, because there are no bars.
Correct. When we moved into the station in 1990-ish, 91, the old cell block had bars in them. These are just, this is pretty solid plexiglass.
You probably hear that banging once in a
while. We do hear the banging, the kicking, you name it. There is nothing that they can, there has still been some accidents. Please go on in. But there were cameras in every cell.
There are cameras in every cell. Okay.
Up here in the corner.
Yep. So you can see if a prisoner is banging his head against the wall.
A prisoner comes in here in the cell, it immediately is put on and monitored from the front desk. Mm-hmm. So the dispatchers, sergeants, lieutenants, police officers, and a prisoner is checked. I think the law says a reasonable amount of time. I want to say, they try to get down here and physically check them every 15 minutes.
Right.
But we can see them from the cameras, located up at the front desk.
Right.
If it would appear that they are going to hurt themselves, we have what we call a restraint chair that we just, we put them in. It doesn't hurt them, but it keeps them from banging their head and mm-hmm. doing what have you. I mean,
right.
we've seen people get up here at the top and throw themselves against the wall. So once they're here, we're responsible for their safety.
Mm-hmm.
That's paramount. Right.
So you get this. This is the bunk.
Yep.
And there's a sink and a toilet.
Correct.
Okay.
Not too comfortable.
Don't want to be here.
Not too comfortable at all.
It's not five star.
No,
right?
No cable.
Yeah.
No television. No satellite. Nothing.
Yeah. But I guess if you're half in the bag, this is as comfortable as
it might be just the thing you need. Yes.
Okay, it looks like very clean. And the thing that I notice is it seems to be spotless.
The state periodically comes out and does inspections.
Okay.
The cells, the cell area, the monitoring system, everything has to be 100% all the time.
Right. I will tell you the temperature is very good in here.
Yes.
It's not too hot. It's not cold. Everything seems to be clean, well painted. There's no chipped paint. And hopefully it doesn't get used that much. But
unfortunately, it does.
It does. Okay. All right.
Yeah.
And this is like a pass-through?
Correct. Serve them their meals and whatnot.
Okay.
We get their meals from the House of Correction.
Oh, you do? Okay.
Yep. They do not get Papa Gino's, Burger King, McDonald's.
That's not good for them anyway.
No, absolutely not. Nope. When we call up to the House of Correction, we know the times that they're serving food up there. The prisoners make the food themselves. So, we arrange breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Mm.
So.
Now, I imagine all the other cells are the same as this, as far
Correct.
As the women's cells and the juvenile
cells. Yes, they're all identical.
Okay.
Yes.
And, of course, they're very close in the vicinity of the area where you fingerprint and you
exactly.
you bring them in here.
Yes. You see the...
This is all... It's close proximity
Correct.
To everything.
This is the one juve cell. Like I said, we have the one juvenile cell.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And the two female cells are in here.
And is this the restraint chair you're talking
it is.
About?
Yes.
Oh, this is interesting.
Yes. It looks a lot worse than it is.
Well, again, it's the plastic.
That's
for the
just
same
like
reason.
What you saw in the back of the cruiser.
And it has the indentation
Correct.
Back here in case you're handcuffed, and it's got the seat, the belts this, in
the
it.
The belts that cross.
That cross over.
And we will actually, the chair will go right into the cell. You'll sit in it right in front of the camera. We have to, when we put a prisoner in it, we have to log it. Why we put him in, the time we put him in, and then he has to be checked. I can't pull that out of my head, but you need to check on them more than you would if you just...
On a regular basis.
Because, it is constricting. Again, does not hurt them.
Mm-hmm.
It's there to calm them down.
Right.
And, I'll say usually, way before 30 minutes comes up,
They're all settled down,
and
right.
okay, I'll stop pounding my head, and
right.
okay, all right, we'll let you out, please,
right.
I
notice it's also got air
yep.
for the legs.
Exactly.
I
mean, like I said, you're in.
So they're not kicking yet.
Should we need to put the arms in, right. You know, or, you know, in here. I mean, it's padded. It's not going to hurt you.
Right. Well, the main thing is that they're not going to hurt anyone, too.
Exactly.